Welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Losing the Neighborhood written by Happy Mom Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now the editorials with respect to paper 2 are very, very important. The reason being, UPSC has been very strict about the checking for general studies mains examination paper 2. So the kind of the analysis that you need to put into your examination while sitting in the examination hall in the papers, it should be of a very high order. Now if you are just reading some current affairs notes and you are just copying the content without infusing the analysis that is required to be infused, even if you're writing one line or two line, then you will not be getting good marks. So what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the Indian foreign policy has changed, how the Indian foreign policy has aberrated, how the Indian foreign policy has veered from the past policy. Now before we analyze about the current state of the Indian foreign policy, it is important to understand and know about what was the past foreign policy of India and why it is said that the past Indian foreign policy, it was very close to become to be an idealistic foreign policy. Now the foreign policy that India had incepted since the days of independence, it was close to idealism. In the old foreign policy, the main focus was on selling the softness of India. The main focus of the foreign policy was on exhibiting the soft aspects that India had possessed since the civilization, Indian civilization, had come into being. So the kind of the foreign policy we were having in the past, it believed in non-interference in the affairs of other countries. It believes in peaceful coexistence. It believes in respecting the sovereignty of other countries. It believes in not indulging in war. It believes in negotiation. It believes in the process of dialogue. It believes in upholding the human rights. It believed in making world a peaceful place to live. Now, it was because of this very foreign policy, India had been able to face such a huge adversary, that is China. Had India would have compromised on its idealistic stance, India would have been defeated very badly in the war with China. But India, because of its idealistic stance and despite not towing the line of United States of America at that point of time, had been able to accrue support of United States of America in thwarting, in dissuading, in stopping China from its intrusion into Indian territory. And it was because of the success of the Indian foreign policy, China called for a unilateral truce from the war. Now, the kind of the foreign policy now we are following a more realistic foreign policy. We have shredded this idealness, and in this realism, India is trying to adopt a macho state. India is trying to be a macho man. India is trying to assert itself. India is trying to adopt the ascendantic stance. First of all, we had adopted the ascendantic stance with respect to Nepal. We had interfered in the internal affairs of Nepal. Then secondly, we had invested lot of logistical and lot of tactical resources in helping Mr. Sirisena in Sri Lanka to win a war. Then we had entered the territory of Myanmar in order to kill the insurgents, northeastern states insurgents. Then India is showing its discontentment with respect to how the Maldives is treating its ex-president. So in all these affairs, we are actually trying to interfere. We are actually trying to jeopardize the sovereign respective state of these countries. We are trying to usurp their autonomy. If not very explicitly, but certainly implicitly. And this is throwing up challenges for India. And this kind of stance that India is following, it is not only against the idealistic stance of Jawaharlal Nehru, but it is also against the realistic stance of Gujral Doctrine. Now this Gujral Doctrine adopted in the year 1996, it wanted the South Asian region to be a region of peaceful coexistence. It wanted India to play the role of Big Brother and to help the small countries. So, what kind of a question you can get from this editorial is about how the Indian foreign policy stance has changed and what kind of benefits it is accruing to India. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our website brainyias.com. Now in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.